Hi friends, welcome to the next lecture on DinoJS. The last few lectures we have seen a router module, and in router module we have specified get users and get specific user and put user, delete user, and we have created the separate file for 404 error if any user is trying to get resource which is not available. We are returning the client error, and we have learned about environment variables, like how to create environment variable, how to use that environment variable in our main.ts file. We have read the main.ts in main.ts file. We have read the configuration file using mod.ts, which is under .env third party library, and using that, and we have created, we have called the function config, and we have stored into environment object. Environment we are calling env.apt_port, and in this lecture we are going to move this logic, like all this logic, into separate module, which is called user controller module, because we don't want it to keep, application is growing, we don't have to keep all the logic, and it is difficult to maintain, difficult to even do any code changes, and debug also it will be very difficult. Now what I am going to do is I am going to create a separate folder, the ROLL controllers, under controllers I am going to create separate class TypeScript file, there controller.ts. I am going to specify the function. Now here I will be moving all router logic, all this logic, into user controller.ts, because this controller is responsible for user related activities, actions. Export defaults, and here we will be having all the get, put, post, delete functions. First function is get function. Let's copy from here get user, control x, copy here, and we need context object ctx of type any. The object is of any type, and we need to have user also, so I'm defining here, I'm going to define under here constant variable. Copy this variable and paste it here. This, and now we need to change, instead of pointing to this one, we need to import the module, user controller module. Import user controller from controllers /, controllers / user controller.ts file. Next, what we are going to do is we have to say use this one, user controller dot, call this function get function. Whenever request comes with the slash users, then this function will be invoked. Under user controllers, get function will be invoked. Let's start the server and check it. Hope nothing will break. Compiling. Once compilation is finished, we'll see server is up in the console. Yes, it's up now. Let's hit the users. It's not put, it is a get method. We are getting the user now. Now we'll move other routes also into user controller. All user specific routers will put into user controller. Next is get specific user. Get user. And here we need ctx context : any. Next get, next post, creating the user. Copy the code from here. Paste it here. We need context object. Again, same thing, ctx : any. Next is put. And here also we need context object ctx colon any. Let's copy or cut it. Control V or update. Update user. Create user. More specific. Create user. Next is delete user. Delete. This is called delete. Delete. Here I'll say delete user. Delete user. And we are going to specify all those here. Remove this one. User controller dot get user. Call this one. When request comes with this URI, then this function will be invoked. Here user controller dot create. Create user controller dot create. Create. What happened? Post. Oh, it is post. It is create. 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 After this, we need to call update method. User controllers dot update method. We are going to call put for update. What do we have? Put. I'm going to make it as update. 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 Next I'm going to use delete. I'm going to call get delete function. Delete. All CRUD operations are finished. Test it our application. And the CRUD operations are finished. Okay. Once the server is up, we will see server is up in the console.log. Okay, it is compiling. It's up now. Let's check it. User. We are getting the users. And specify one user. The ID one. I will get return one. If I make put, I will get put response. Update user. If I call delete, I will get delete user. 200 OK and delete user. And if I call post, post will not have any ID because we are creating freshly, right? We will not have anything. Create user. So what we have done is we have moved all router logic from router.ts to user controller.typescript file. Instead of repeating, okay, what we are doing, we are repeating this router.get every time, right? Instead of that, let's remove this one. Even don't need to have this one. Post. Next is put. Same is applicable for delete. Previously, we have around 13 or 14 lines of code. Now it 15 lines of code. Now it is max to max 15 or 10 lines of code. You see, these are 10 lines of code. And here we removed all the logic from router to we put into under user controller. Here we don't have any logic. If application is keep growing, it is difficult to maintain and difficult to debug the issues. So we moved all the logic to user controller separate file. And it's working. Thank you, friends.